So here you are hustling, trying to take care of the guests, bringing the catering business, trying to take care of your employees, trying to do some marketing. You need to know a little bit about bookkeeping. You need to have the kitchen. You need to solve the problems. You need to know how to do CPR. You need to do pretty much everything. And you do, more importantly, want to keep your business open and successful at least as long as you can. So this is the biggest challenge I found. I do consulting for lots of restaurants. A lot of them come to me and tell me, Sham, the quality of our waiters is decreasing. They're all flooding away, going to restaurants that are either chains, high volumes, lots of seats, full bars. We do not have that. And you know what? We are really scared about the future of our business. And this is something I wish I can bring to your attention before the time comes when it is too late. Guys, you need to invest more in your employees. I did lots of market research. I'm reaching out to people that call themselves gurus of the industry. And guess what? They give you fancy spreadsheets. They ask you to actually rechange your entire menu. They literally ask you to jump through some hoops for which the real business owner, the restaurant owner who is right there in the trenches, does not have time for. I want you to invest in the most important employee in your business, which is you. Guys, this is why you do not have quality waiters to help you make the best out of your restaurant. And these are a couple of little pointers. Some of them may stick, some of them may not. If I can teach you something new, fantastic. If I didn't teach you anything new and you just confirmed your current knowledge, this is fantastic. I want you to take some time and look at your restaurant. Do you enjoy going there? And if you do not enjoy going there, and even if you do enjoy going there, put yourself in the shoes of your employees. When they walk inside the restaurant, do they enjoy being there? Truth of the matter is that the experienced waiter is the one that can actually help you make lots of money and blow up of proportion the reputation of your restaurant are working for finer dining restaurants, higher seat capacity where they have higher volumes, and just pretty much restaurants that have way more money to blow up on labor and things of the kind. Maybe you do not have the best location in the world. That is not a problem. The best investment you can do for now is to invest on your most important employee, which is you, my friend. Through continual education, stay on top of technology. You can tell me, blah, 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 this is easy. Guys, this is what's going on. The waiters that normally would have worked inside your restaurants are out there working for Uber and Lyft, driving like zombies all day long, making that money and still getting the edge of that human interaction that they originally came for when they start working for your restaurant. You need to have an amazing hiring and firing process, a way to motivate your team, to keep them on track. And you know, you need to invest on your most important employee, which is you. Taking some time off is perfectly fine. Tell me, Sham, man, I can't think about taking time off right now. I'm understaffed. I perfectly understand that. You need to revise how you spend your day. And you need to spend some time in the products of your love, which is your restaurant. It doesn't have to be too fancy. You will be amazed at how some couple of little decoration in the restaurant will make it a little bit more friendly. Maybe touching up the paint. Some little details that can really take it from that restaurant that's actually falling into pieces to the one that's actually attracting and keeping your employees. I am not talking, guys, about bringing in the clients. Just focus on your employees. If you take good care of your employees, do training for them, love them more, show them more love, you know, be in the trenches with them. I know it may be hard. You're going to tell me, Sham, I can't, you know, I don't have a proper front of the house person. It does not matter. You have to work out a way to be close to your team, spend time with them, talk to them nicely, all these kind of things. This can be kind of hard, especially if you have been in the industry for so long. You end up being a little bit jaded, right? So this is what you need to do to make sure you keep your business on track and do not lose it to the big chains, to the bigger restaurants that have more money to invest on the flashy, blinky things. You do not need to be super flashy, you need to be blinky, but you need to be genuine. What happened is that you came to this restaurant with a huge heart. Yes, I know you did. That's the only reason you would go into a business where so many of them fail, because there is something that attracts you into it. Maybe it was the drinks, maybe it was the dancers, maybe it was the food, maybe just the idea of being self-employed. So you came with a big heart, and this heart of yours has been torn into pieces. pieces little by little by little by little. And at the end, you get drained. So I want you to look at yourself in the mirror and say, you know what? How am I really feeling? Do I need to rest? And you know, the best thing you can do is invest in what goes inside here, what goes in your eyes, and what comes out of your mouth. There is a process, there is people teaching it out there. You need to seek that knowledge to stay on top of your game. If it means just watching a little video, 5 minutes a day, 4 minutes a day, at the beginning, maybe wake up 10 minutes before, whatever the situation may be. And I hear you guys right there. You know, I have some pastries that are like, dude, I'm awake at 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning. I have a family, I have kids, I don't have the time to do that. But this is your business. This is the original reason you went into this, was to actually have a lifestyle. And my thing to you, my main message behind this video is that you need to make sure you capture the proper employees and you keep them. And there is a method behind that. There is tools, there is method, things that have done it right. And you know, lots of people go into this business, you know, they're amazingly cooks, but they're sucks at human resources. They're very good at human resources and cooking, but they're very bad at marketing. And you know, I am not talking to you about just revamping the entire business, because lots of counselors out there just will go and, you know, they will give you more than what you asked for. You know, you just need to do things at your pace. It's not about changing. It does not help to change the seats of a sinking boat. I repeat, it does not help to change the seats of a sinking boat. The easiest, most cost-efficient way to boost the sales, the marketing of your place, the vibe of it, and things of the kind is one, you. Two is your employees. And the internet is full of information on what you can do to motivate them. And guess what? You just found a friend that may just be able to help you with that. Or maybe not. But you know, this is what you need to do. And little enhancement to the look of your restaurant. I go to so many restaurants. The food is delicious. But you know, when I look at the employees, they look miserable. Because man, they have served all this delicious food that's actually not served in nice plates. Or they have these nice plates, but the decor is just not appealing to them. The demographics of your waiters are also changing, guys. The people that are coming and working for your restaurant are no more the engineer or the medical legal researcher that actually wants to enhance their social life by having human interaction. Those are kids that's actually going inside the restaurant business in order to learn more. You know, this is the way the waiter job is being sold right now. It is not a serious profession. It's something that you do to have a blast when you have in your 20s. You know, and you need to change that if you want to make it past 2019. The kids are coming inside the restaurant. I'm like, man, the corporate culture of this restaurant is horrible. If I go work at Chili's, you know, I mean, not going to learn as much, but I mean, it's going to be at least more fun. So you need to add the fun factor. And this is fun for your employees, and you are going to benefit from it. And you tell me, Sham, you know, I spent the first 5 years of my business. I'm like, dude, I had so much fun. And you know what? Now I'm ready to do. You cannot take the fun out of the restaurant business. The moment you stop having fun, you need to revise. Check what you are doing wrong. Self-improve, be careful what you're listening, who you're hanging out with, you know, positive talk, positive vibration, and more importantly, do the little thing that matters. It's not about reinvesting in a brand new decoration in the restaurant. You have to be smart with your money if you want to be able to make the rent payments and the labor costs. You know, it's, you can either have like three literally very sad little waiters that are just there because guess what? They were not able to get hired anywhere else, or actually have like one superstar that will make you people come back, that will help you, that will say, hey boss, I'm loving working here. I would love for you to actually go home early. I got the closing covered. Everything is done. Go to your family. So imagine having one, two, three. Imagine having your entire team pumped up. And there are secrets behind that. Things that you can do to lock them in or whatnot. Well, this video is going almost on 9 minutes. Thank you so much for watching. I want to say thank you for devoting your life on making the life of other people better. And you know what? By applying this little principle, you can do this, guys. You will definitely stay in business by 2019 and not lose the big chain or the people that have way more money than you and I have. Until we meet again, remember, the secret ingredient is love. And this was the responsible restaurant order.